Photoshop is my software of choice, and despite not being a painter, my favorite and most used tool is the brush tool. I use it to mask out images and add and adjust shadows and lighting, pinpoint adjustments and other color corrections, but most importantly, create the stylized texture and details I like to add to my own work. Nothing I do is possible without the brush tool. The worst tool is super easy. It's the frame tool. I don't know what it does or what it's for. Okay, I do know. It's a simpler way to mask square things, I guess, but I don't see how it was deemed just so essential it had to be added right to the middle of my toolbar. So now it's just something I accidentally click on every once in a while. I'm sure it's useful to someone, but it's not to me.
For the best tool, the first one that comes into my mind is the Shape Builder tool, mainly because it's a real-time saver when I'm dealing with a lot of vector shapes. In the past, the Pathfinder panel was my go-to option whenever I needed to combine vector paths in Illustrator, but then once the Shape Builder tool came out, things got a lot easier. Moving to the worst tool, I'm not suggesting that it is useless, it's just that I never managed to get along with this tool, and I'm talking about the Perspective Grid tool. I know I've seen people that can make a real good use of it, and I suggest you to give it a try, but for now, for me, I choose to pass it.
Don't have to pick one because there are many. I would say the primary text frame, it can be easily set up on the new document window. You can copy and paste long text that can be automatically threaded throughout the document's pages, and then you can go in and format the text and add your own images. So it is a great time saver. Worst tool, I would say the page tool handles. They're just not intuitive enough. So if you want to resize a page using the page tool, you can go to the properties bar and use the drop-down menu to choose a size. But if you try dragging the page tool handles, they just never stick where you want them to. And over the years, I learned that you have to be pressing the option key and then drag the handles for them to stick where they have to or where you want them to.
Stuck on the motion graphics for your new video project? Jumpstart your creative process with Envato Elements and get studio-quality motion graphics templates for every editing program. Fast-track your ideas and deliver your best work with time to spare. Get everything you need for exceptional videos in one place for one low cost.
I use Adobe Premiere all the time. My favorite tool has got to be Remix. Like you, I use a lot of music for my projects, and oftentimes I need to get the length of a track just right. Sometimes it's too long, sometimes it's too short, and instead of doing it like in the old days where you kind of had to go and grab a track and copy and paste it and do all sorts of trickery to just create a simple loop, you can open Remix and with a click of a button do that within seconds. The feature that I've had most problems with has got to be nesting clips. It's great that you could grab a bunch of clips and just merge them together, but the problem is that not every plugin or effect will work on that nested clip. I find these limitations to be quite arbitrary, since they can actually mess up the effects that you've put on individual clips.
My favorite or my most used Adobe tool at the moment is After Effects. So the Properties panel, I think, is the best new tool in After Effects in ages. So in years gone by, to change things like the position or the opacity or the rotation or things like that, you would hit a hotkey on your keyboard or twirl that menu down in the transform menu on each layer, and you would end up just having a whole stack of layers that were open, keyframes everywhere, and it was all a bit gross. You'd lose track of what you're doing. But now we've got the Properties panel, which has all of that information in there, so all you need to do is select the layer that you're working on. All of that information is up in your properties panel. What's bad about it is the very steep learning curve, almost at its most base function. Especially if you've come from Premiere Pro, you might be familiar with some of these tools, but then you come over into this environment in After Effects, completely different layout, completely different GUI. It's quite technical. The way you render things is a bit different. It might feel a bit daunting to dive in.
Hmm. My best tool would have to be the Pages panel, Parent Pages to be a bit more exact. I mainly use it for adding footers and repeating design elements to all of my pages or spreads. Using Parent Pages has made creating multi-page documents so much easier for me. I no longer have to add page numbers manually to each page because all of this is taken care of through Parent Pages. My worst tool is InDesign's Effects Panel. The Effects Panel is basic compared to Photoshop's Effects Panel, which is also known as Layer Styles. It's not as robust, and I find myself spending hours in InDesign trying to get a decent effect compared to just minutes in Photoshop.
These days, my absolute favorite tool in Adobe Lightroom Classic is the Select Subject tool. Call me old-fashioned, but I've been a little bit weary of all of the AI tools rolling out, but this Select Subject tool is a real lifesaver. In a portrait edit, I'm almost always creating a custom mask. That way I can increase the contrast and sharpness on my subject, giving them a little bit of an extra pop. In the olden days, we used to have to use a paintbrush and manually paint in the sections of our image that we wanted to create a custom selection with. But now, Lightroom can auto-detect your subject, and at the click of a button, using the Select Subject tool, create a seamless mask that you're ready to edit with. The worst tool in Adobe Lightroom Classic is the Dehaze slider. It's not that it doesn't do its job well, it's just for it to get the prime real estate all the way up in the top of the Basics tab in the Lightroom workspace, it really isn't that useful. The Dehaze tool is used specifically to increase or decrease the amount of haze in an image, which I don't know about you, but I don't find myself needing more than maybe once or twice a year. Don't take it personally, Dehaze tool. It's just you don't belong to be up there with the juggernauts such as exposure or saturation or even shadows.
My favorite tool to use in Adobe Illustrator is the Pen tool. It's an extremely versatile tool to use with different modes such as curve control, the add anchor points tool that you can use in all sorts of different situations. I use it for almost all of my projects, whether it's for creating precise strokes and shapes or for making adjustments to complex illustrations or editing existing artwork. The tool that I find is the worst in Adobe Illustrator is the shortcut Control H or Command H on the Mac. Sometimes I hit this shortcut by accident and it hides all the anchor points and edges in Illustrator, which can be annoying if you're in the middle of working and if you're like me, you forget what the shortcut key is.